Alright, hey guys, it's been a while since I've done one of these. Unboxing a cube like all the cool kids. This one is a Diana Zanchi, old school style, but it's got one of those fancy magnetic feature things that the kids love these days, alright? So I got it because I'm old school and I love throwback to Zanchi and Guhong, you know. So, obviously this has been, like, lubed up or greased up by SpeedCubeShop.com. Thank you very much, Cameron, for sending these over. And, this is just a very, very smooth turning cube, and I like the feel. Super, super clean. It doesn't feel like you're, it just feels really good. It doesn't feel like you're cutting, it doesn't feel like you're cheating. I don't know, with the newer cubes these days, it feels like weird, like you're cheating. I don't know how to explain it. But this feels like you actually have to do your turns in order to do the turns, if you know what I mean. But yeah, this should be a good little... I lost my other main one. I don't know what happened to it, but whatever. And the next one is going to be a 7x7. Yeah. Stab myself. I actually had trouble finding my package because I probably put the wrong address, so I had to go a block over to the address it was probably delivered to. After trying to contact FedEx about it, they were kind of helpless as hell. But this poor Mexican lady, I knocked on her door, and she was sick, probably with COVID. Luckily, I had Omicron, so hopefully, like, I'm immune to Omicron if she had it or whatever, but I knocked on the door, and she was showing through the window. I asked her, like, hey, I'm looking for a package, you know, I was using hand signals, and she said, oh, okay, she showed me the package, and it happened to be mine, and she gave it to me. She said she cleaned it all off and whatnot, you know, so, but, yeah, I kind of had a little kersnuffle with getting this, package delivered. So, this is the MGC 7x7. Ooh, and I've never had a 7x7, like, actually, like, a good 7x7. This one is magnetic. And, I'm already, like, messing up here. Alright, so, well, fuck it, we'll do it live! Why is this so difficult for me right now? What did I do? Anyways, it turns really good. I'm just a noob. Alright. It's just, I think, like, my fingers want to turn. These layers are pretty small. I think that's what it is. And it's a really good size cube for speed cubing. But you got to be careful with the turning of the layers, okay? So, the outside layers turn pretty good. Blah, blah, blah. Very accurate. The magnets, you can tell, help a lot. So, this is going to be a really good cube. Once I figure out how to speed cube these things, you know. I don't know what my PR with what that one is. I don't know. Like 3-4 minutes. I'm so slow when it comes to that one. Anyway, this is the Mega Minx something or other. I don't know, YJ Mega Minx. The one that has like a weird, like a kind of circular kind of grip things. And I got it just because I wanted something else to play with. Ooh. I don't even do Mega Minx, but this feels really good. So maybe I'll be speed solving Mega Minx sometime soon and breaking records. Who knows? And then the last one, of course, is going to be this 10x10. And I just wanted to get something bigger. You know, I never get any big cubes, and I thought it was time for me to get like something bigger than a 7x7 or something. So this is the Sheng Xiao 10x10. Okay, this is the biggest cube I ever owned. And holy crap, does it look small, dude. This thing is so small. Wow. Okay. I thought it would be a lot bigger, but if you look at it compared to the 7x7, it's kind of like a similar, almost a similar size, dude. That's pretty crazy. I mean, obviously this one's bigger. Oh no, there goes my Mega Me. Oh, I never really practiced that anyway, so. Ooh, this is interesting. Wow. Ooh, ooh-ee. Oh, that feels. Ooh, that is thick. That is thick. With two C's thick. Ooh, it's kind of greasy. You could tell it's been lubed up, and I appreciate that. Cameron or whoever might have lubed this up. I appreciate you. I appreciate you for taking the time to prepare my puzzles, alright? You need to get a raise. Cameron, whoever did this, give him a raise. But I'm just turning the outside layers in. It's a little bit, honestly, it's more than I can expect. I have low expectations when it comes to big cubes. It's more than I can expect for turning-wise out of the box for a 10x10, the outer layers. Let's see. Sometimes, okay, if I'm trying to turn, half of the cube, because it's a 10x10, so there is actually half the cube, and I don't hold the layer exactly where it's supposed to be, it might, like, catch the other layer, and whatever, I mean. So it will definitely take some getting used to, and I gotta be more gentle with this one, as opposed to like the 7x7. And yeah, already a piece got kind of caught there. But we're, you know, this is a 10x10, so we're kind of in uncharted territory here, you know? So a piece kind of came out. Whatever. I kind of expect these things, especially when I'm just getting used to the turning of the cube. But it should be fun to play with once I actually break it in. You know, and I'm really excited to have these, so I think that's about it for the opening. So this is my new cube collection. And thank you again, Cameron, speedcubeshop.com. If you ever need a puzzle, make sure you head over there. All right, thanks a lot.